Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Deep Biology. In this tutorial, we will learn about Tarnow syndrome, which is an important chromosomal abnormality found in female. Actually, Tarnow syndrome arises due to non-disjunction at meiosis during oogenesis process. We know that human chromosomes have 23 pairs of chromosomes. Among these, autosomes are 22 pairs and 1 pair are sex chromosomes. Usually, we denote female sex chromosome as XX and male sex chromosome as XY. Due to aneuploidy at some steps in meiosis during cell divisions, some deformities seen in subsequent cells. Aneuploidy involves changes in chromosomes number by additions or deletions of less than a whole set. In this case, organism gains or losses one or more chromosomes but not a complete set. In normal female, twice the number of chromosomes is present, that means 46 chromosomes. Due to aneuploidy or monosomic type of aneuploid conditions, the female have deficit of one chromosome at their sex chromosome sets, and this condition is known as Tarnow syndrome. In this case, the total number of chromosomes remain 45 instead of 46 due to lack of one sex chromosome in their sex chromosome sets. A sex chromosome monosomic in human being is Tarnow syndrome. They have only 44 chromosomes plus one sex chromosome. Approximately one among 2,500 female newborn with only one sex chromosome are observed. Tarnow syndrome only human monosomy that is viable. That means their life expectancy are so long. In most cases, Tarnow syndrome are not inherited. The syndrome known as Tarnow syndrome after the name of Dr. Henry Tarnow, who discovered this disease first in 1938. This is an epigram of female with Tarnow syndrome. If we look into the karyotypic characteristics of the chromosome sets, in chromosome sets of 23, we can see that here, instead of two X chromosomes, only one chromosome remains present. Other have deficit or loss of second chromosomes. This is the condition of Tarnow syndrome. The common phenotypic traits or symptoms or characteristics of Tarnow syndrome is retarded sexual development. That is, their gonads are in rudiment stages and they have no menstrual cycles. Due to this, sometimes these Tarnow syndromes are called female gonadal dysgenesis. They are usually sterile. They have short statues. They have webbing of skin in neck regions. They have short foot metacarpal hypoblastic nails. They have cardiovascular abnormalities. They also have impaired hearing. The most notable characters or deities, they are actually short in statues. Shield shapes are shaped thorax. Widely spaced nipples are also present. Shortened metacarpal pore on their hands. They have small fingernails. Their elbows are deformity are also observed. They have rudimentary ovaries and fold of skin in the neck regions. They have poor breast development in comparison to normal females. They have characteristic facial features. These are the common traits we can observe in case of Turner syndromes. Now the point is how this syndrome develops. This syndrome developed at meiosis due to non-disjunctions during oogenesis process. In normal case, during meiosis 1, the chromosome segregated in daughter cells and their chromosome number reduced almost half and their daughter cell receives half of the set of parental chromosomes or 23 chromosomes. That means if we consider parental cell have twice n or 46 chromosomes, their daughter cell receives n or 23 chromosomes in each cell. And in further process, in meiotic or meiosis 2, this cell produced 4 daughter cells having 23 chromosomes in each cells. Due to this, meiosis 1 is considered reduction division because here the chromosome number are reduced in stage meiosis 1, and the meiotic 2 division is known as equational divisions because here chromosome are not reduced, remain intact in every cell, that is 23 in 4 cells. If this is the normal oogenesis process, but in case of non-disjunction at meiosis 1, one cell receives one additional chromosomes and became 24 instead of 23. While other cell have one deficit or loss of one chromosome and remain as 22 instead of 23. And in meiosis or meiotic 2, this cell give rise to two cells having only 22 chromosome each. If another case, if we consider non-disjunction occurring in meiosis 2 levels, in this case also one cell receives one additional chromosomes and have chromosome number became 24 instead of 23, which is the normal case. And while other progeny cells have one deficit chromosome or loss of one chromosome and remain only 22 chromosomes. And this is the condition of n minus 1, that means 23 minus 1 equal to 22. Actually, these cells, when fertilized with normal sperms having 23 chromosome and receives one paternal X chromosome and became fertilized, they produce 45 number of chromosome instead of 46 due to lack of one X chromosome here. And this is the conditions how Turner syndrome develops. In this way, due to aneuploidy at meiosis 1 and meiosis 2, and this is the case of monosomic conditions, Turner syndrome develops. This is all about Turner syndrome. I hope that after watching this video, you will be able to solve any question asked from these topics. Thank you.